Welcome. In this next section, we're going to look at optimizing the network performance. Optimizing network performance makes up somewhere between 5 and 10% of the exam, but there's still several topics and subtopics to be familiar with. The two main ones are designing the network infrastructure for optimizing Microsoft Teams phone performance. The other is implementing the actual network topology. There are tools, there are processes, there are best practices, and there are minimums that you want to be familiar with related to both of these topics. Let's look at the optimal Microsoft Teams phone performance. If we look at the sections that could be covered in the exam with this topic, they're going to include determining network readiness for Microsoft Teams. Be familiar with the tools that you can use to determine that network readiness, including the network planner and the best practices, the minimum connectivity requirements for both bandwidth and connectivity, the ports, the URLs, that Microsoft Teams is going to use. You want to use the network planner to design the network requirements, and it's going to be important for you to actually download and run the network planner a couple of times to be familiar with what's in there, what you can do with it, what the output of the network planner is going to look like. Then you're going to want to make sure that you perform a network analysis using the Microsoft Teams network analysis tool. That's fairly straightforward. It's easy to download. Download it and run it yourself on your own machine, at home, or at the office to see how you feel about that network analysis. Get familiar again with the inputs and the outputs of the tool. You're also going to want to look at designing and validating that local internet breakout. You know, we'd say time and time again that Microsoft Teams should have as direct and as optimal connectivity as possible to Microsoft 365. Look into what that means by reading the principles of network connectivity, looking at the design principles, ensuring that internet egress and DNS name resolution are as close to the client as possible, what traffic can be proxied if it has to be, but more importantly, what traffic should not be and why you want to use the UDP ports, including being familiar with the UDP port ranges. You're also going to want to look at and make sure you understand VPN best practices and the need for split tunneling. Definitely don't want to have clients routing all of their traffic over VPN to the corporate office before it then goes back out to Microsoft 365. Look at best practices, look at recommendations, and understand that such forced tunneling creates latency and can sometimes constrain port access that a direct connection doesn't have the same problem with. Finally, get familiar with quality of service. Look at the QS requirements and policies. Make sure you understand where QS works and where it does not, when it can be a good solution and when it's not going to provide any real benefit. And then go through and configure QoS policies. Go into the Teams Admin Center, work through and set up the QoS policies. Look at Group Policy Editor. Think about what's required from a hardware perspective, the routers and switches that are on the network to be able to actually support quality of service. You go through all of that, you'll be in pretty good shape for the first of those two sections in this part of the exam. The next is going to be implementing the network topology. And the four topics that go into this are, frankly, probably thought exercises for you more than things that you would have hands-on knowledge and understanding of. But work your way through configuring a network topology. Go through the call quality dashboard and call analytics. Upload information into those tools, even if you're just making up generic subnets and fake offices. Go through the effort. Add those, run through the tools with that information there. Look at where call quality dashboard and call analytics can divide out information based on subnet or location. Make sure that you've also got a network roaming policy configured and assigned. Go through the tax, set it up, set it for users so that you're familiar with what the interfaces look like, what the settings are, what is and is not an option within each of them. If you've gone through those exercises, if you've had a little bit of hands-on with that, you'll be in good shape whether the questions are theoretical or they're practical hands-ons with the SIMs. Make sure that you know what you've got going on there. To study for this section of the exam, several resources are on this page. Each of these links will take you to the appropriate areas. Again, principles of network connectivity, the URLs and IP address ranges. No, you don't need to memorize all of those, but be familiar with them, understand what they're about, pay attention to the port ranges. Make sure that you've read the TechNet or the docs articles that are there. Download and run the tools so that you've done that before you get into the exam, you're familiar with what's there. And then the last two links on this page are videos that you can watch on YouTube that go a very good way into explaining these concepts, making sure that you're familiar with what's out there, and it's a great way to reinforce the learning. Go through those and you'll be in good shape for this exam.